Ms. Aram, we're here at the investment conference, and you, if I can say so, just recently became an investor in Ukraine. If we discuss the challenges which a foreign investor is facing here in the Ukrainian market, what would these be?
The challenges for a foreign investor in Ukraine, we're very happy to say that not all of them apply to a solar investor. The solar investor has to face some of the total challenges of the Ukrainian market. One of the challenges is bureaucracy. There is slow pace in the production of tangible results regarding the development, especially if we want to speak for our market. The basic challenges are the development and the interconnection of the projects. These are things that should be improved and would be good to be improved immediately. The second thing that we would like to see being improved immediately is the legislation regarding the interconnection. The feed-in tariff is awarded to the company after the total construction has been already finished, which means the investor receives the right to get paid for his project after having injected $10 million on a project. So visibility and logic says that this process has to be before the investment and not after the investment, so that the government does not have the ability to recall anything from the initially expected. However, still Ukraine remains a country where investment worth the try.
If we're talking about your particular company, what were your main objectives of coming to the Ukrainian market? Why did you decide to come here?
Yeah, our positioning in Ukraine is primarily financial. The Ukrainian tariff is one of the highest, maybe the highest in Europe. So the returns are pretty good. Ukraine is part of Europe, so the basics regarding the legislation, the juridical system are in place. Of course, there is a lot of room for improvement, but the basics are here. And the second thing is that we believe that geostrategically, Ukraine will play a very, very significant role energetically in the future because of its geographical positioning. The geographical positioning of Ukraine is in between two continents, and we believe that Ukraine will be a point of interest in terms of energy for the next 20 or 30 years.
Now talking about the renewable energy, how lucrative is this market here in Ukraine?
To be honest, it's good. To be honest, in terms of revenue, if compared to any other Western European country, the revenues of Ukraine are better than they are currently in Germany or in UK or in France. However, when we make an investment decision, we have to take into consideration also other criteria like safety, visibility, stability, taxation, country risk, currency risk, etc. Still, the balance is positive for Ukraine.
What about corruption? Ukraine is known for being a corrupt country. How do you deal with that?
Yeah, actually, we do not deal with that. The law dealt himself with that. Obviously, the government wanted to implement as much as green energy as possible. So the development process selected, where the corruption could play a role if it was complicated, is very, very straightforward and simple. That means that there is no too much room for corruption in this case. But if we speak about corruption in general, yes, corruption is a basic issue for Ukraine, even if it does not touch us directly as solar producers, and has to be hit radically, because it is unthinkable that 3 or 5 or 10 people harm the future of 45 million people.
How much of support do you feel from the government for investors like yourself?
Actually, for the time being, we are pretty satisfied. Let me give you a basic example. Payments in a country of a European Union like Greece for solar projects are being delayed 8 or 9 months to be made. Ukraine has no track record of a delayed payment. So that means that the cash flow is absolutely visible and the obligations of the SPV towards the bank are being fulfilled just on time. We truly believe that the government is committed to green energy. Green energy provides them with a cleaner energy, with a level of energetical independence. And we believe that for Ukraine, it's a great opportunity. The great opportunity is to prove in the investments world that Ukraine is a good environment for making investments, and through solar energy will attract more investments in other sectors, in other domains, having the solar energy experience of the investment as a pilot.
Understood. Well, we can only wish you best of luck in your endeavor here in the Ukraine market, and thank you very much for talking to us.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.